And now we're looking forward to his next fight. And Mike will tell you that, this fight's dedicated to Magomed. It'll have his name on his trunks. He's also donating a portion of his purse there. So we're excited about that. He's going to fight Carlos Takam, who's 29-1. He's from France. And that's one step closer to his goal of winning a heavyweight championship in the world. Both fighters, both Mike and Gennady, are trained by Abel Sanchez, who's got probably the best training camp in the world, the summit in Big Bear Lake. And then Gennady's fight is February 1st. He made such a big splash last year in Monte Carlo that they wanted him back. And the purpose of this fight is to stay very active. Adama's a very credible challenger. He's number 3 in the world by the IBO, and he went the distance with Daniel Gill in a close fight in Australia. And it's we're looking to capitalize on what Gennady did from last year. He really had a breakout year in 2013 with the help of HBO. He had a number of numerous awards, Fighter of the Year, Knockout of the Year. He had actually 2 candidates for Ishida and for Magomed for Knockout of the Year last year. And we're looking to build on what he accomplished in 2013. Moving forward to 2014. That being said, maybe I can have Tony Walker is here representing HBO. We have a very close relationship with HBO, and they've supported both Gennady and Mike. So if Tony can say a few words on behalf of both guys, then we can move on to the fighters.
Yeah, absolutely. January 18th, we kick off World Championship Boxing for the year. We're really excited to have a guy like Mike Perez in a good fight, leading off the telecast on the undercard of Boutte and Pascal. Mike is an up-and-comer for sure. He's great skills, big-time heavyweight, gets hard, he looks the part, fans like him, so we're excited to have him on HBO. And we just continue to work with K2 and Tom to showcase these guys throughout the year as much as possible, because they're good for boxing. Hopefully their careers can progress and we'll be with them. Gennady is our partner. Hopefully we'll see him lots of times on HBO this year. We're working with K2 to try to get the February fight on. Not done yet, logistical issues of doing a broadcast from Monaco, but we're working. So we'll see. And we'll let you guys know as soon as it's done. And after that show, we hope to get Ifkalat if Gennady wins. We hope to have him on HBO many more times this year. So it's all good.
Yeah, we're looking forward to that too. Abel, maybe you can say a few words about Mike first, and then we can go into Gennady.
Well, as we discussed in the last press conference when Mike was here, he's a project that is very rewarding for me as a coach, because I'm getting the discipline and dedication from him to make him that star that American fans are looking for as a heavyweight. He's got the kind of style that's pleasing for TV, and his always being in condition. He's always looking like a fighter instead of these fat guys that getting here in the States. It's going to make it attractive for all of us fight fans.
What I'd like to do now is to introduce Mike. He's rated number 5 in the WBC in the world. As most of you saw, his fight, breakout fight in America at Madison Square Garden on HBO November 2nd. He fought a guy that really nobody wanted to fight. When I was negotiating a deal with Samson, he was just looking to get a fight for Magomed. And when Mike stepped up and took a challenge to fight for the WBC, the USNBC title, it was great fight between 2 undefeated fighters. As we mentioned, unfortunately what happened with Magomed, be in our prayers, but Mike's dedicated his next fight. One thing that he has asked me every day since the fight is, where's my belt? So since it's Christmas time, I wanted to present him.
We're looking at you.
You can see the fits.
Oh, what title?
Thank you. This is the USNBC title. It's basically the champion of the United States. But he's rated number five, and we're looking forward to, this will be his first title defense of the title. And again, it'll be on HBO. Mike, if you want to say a few words about the training with Abel up in Big Bear, and also looking forward to fighting in Canada.
First of all, I want to wish all the best recuperation of Magomed. I gonna dedicate this fight for him because he's a great fighter, a warrior. Now training going very good, barring everything in Big Bear with the coach everywhere on the team. Looking forward to January 18th and going to do my best. All focus on January 18th. Hopefully fight as soon as possible for what I did. And ready to go again.
As all of you know, Vitaly was unable to defend his WBC title. He was a very proud WBC champion, longtime reigning champion. In fact, one of the few or only people that I can think of who could have a four-year break and come back and fight right away again for the title when he took his championship back from St. Peter at the time. The title is now vacant, and this is one step towards winning the WBC championship of the world for Mike, and so we're looking forward to him stepping forward into that space. Everybody knows Gennady. He has two belts, although he's taking a lot of photos with him. So, Gennady, if you want to say a few words about going back to Monte Carlo, fighting Adama, and then you know just what you're looking forward to accomplishing in 2014.
Many words.
You gonna translate
him? Oh, okay. I'm ready. I hope it's a great fight.
February 1st.
It's New Year. I'm ready for New Year. I think same like last year. Great year. Hope a great fight. I hope I have a lot of great fights. I'm ready.
I mean, all of us sitting at this table, you know, our choice for fight of the year was Gennady. I mean, he made four title defenses, had four impressive KO victories. I believe he was the only fighter that was in the running that made an existing champion vacate a title when Daniel Gill decided not to fight Gennady, but to take a different fight in Australia. A fight like Ishida, a guy that was never stopped before, now you knocked him out in three rounds. And then you had a fight like Matthew Macklin, who was clearly top five, top ten, middleweight, and proved himself against Sergio Martinez and Felix Sturm. Now he had the same result, knocked out in three. And I think Abel will tell you that as Gennady's perceived competition gets better, just like with the Macklin fight, when Macklin was a very solid, dangerous middleweight contender, that's when you'll see the best of Gennady come out. And so if everything goes the right way, February 1st against Adama, we're looking forward. We already, he said, you know, if Cotto has a hard time making the fight with Sergio, that he would step in either against Cotto or against Sergio. And, that's a great fight. It's a great unification fight with Sergio Martinez. Sergio kind of has the mantle of, what he's accomplished as a top middleweight, but we clearly think that Gennady's a top middleweight at this time, and so he's ready to take any challenge and fight anyone that may.